Suppose that the probability that a person who buys a lottery ticket wins the lottery is 1 over a million. What is the probability that a person who buys a lottery ticket does not win the lottery? So we're asked to find the probability of not winning the lottery. And whenever you see a question that has the word not in it, it's always good to think about the complement. The complement. So what is the complement? Let's do a quick review. So if we have a particular event that we're looking for, here the event is winning the lottery, but it could be some broad event. The complement of the event, this event, means all the outcomes, which would mean that the event does not happen. And we call that a E tilde, or whatever it is, tilde. So this little symbol here, this is called a tilde, a T-I-L-D-E, tilde. So for instance, here we could say that the event winning the lottery, we could denote that as W, and not winning the lottery is W tilde. So if we were flipping a coin, for instance, we could say that heads is one event, getting heads, and getting not heads is another event, H tilde. And here H tilde is the same as T, because tails means that you don't get heads. Or alternatively, if we had a pack of cards, we might say that the event we're looking for is hearts. And so we might be looking for drawing out a card from a standard 52 pack of cards, and we might be looking for a heart card. And we might say that the complement of hearts, say hearts tilde, well, hearts tilde would mean anything that is a diamond or a club, or a spade. That would mean not hearts. And one of our fundamental theorems about probability is that the probability that an event occurs plus the probability that the event does not occur must equal one. And that's because the event occurring or the event not occurring together, they make up all the possible outcomes that we could get. And so consequently, together the probability of these two happening must equal one, because the sum of all of the probabilities of all the different outcomes of an experiment must equal one. So here we know that the probability of winning plus the probability of not winning equals one. And we're also given the probability of winning. We're given the probability of winning equals one over a million. So let's substitute probability of winning 1 over a million into this equation. So then we get 1 over a million, probability of winning, plus the probability of not winning equals 1. Well, we're looking for the probability of not winning. That's what we're trying to find. So let's subtract 1 over a million from both sides. So then we'll get probability of not winning equals 1 minus 1 over a million, and we can rewrite this one here as a million over a million, such that we get a common denominator. So we could write this as a million over a million minus one over a million. So here, a million minus one is 999,999 over a million. So the probability of not winning the lottery is 999,999 over a million. So it's fairly likely that this person will unfortunately not win the lottery.